Now I met up with Father Alan on the slopes of Mount Zion at the Church of Galakanti in Jerusalem, and I asked him when this church was built.
The church was built more or less in 1930. There were some excavation before, and when they found the place where Jesus came, where he was arrested in prison, so they decided to build a church, and the church was built in this time.
So why did they build the church actually here on this site?
Precisely because they have the conviction that Jesus was arrested in this part of the city. We are not sure exactly the place because, you know, in the first century it was difficult to know where exactly the event arrived. But we think that there are a lot of good reason to think that Jesus... anyway, Jesus came, by the way. You saw maybe the way from Gethsemane until the cenacle where Jesus has the Last Supper. And after that also, when Jesus was arrested, he came from Gethsemane in this way, who is down. You can see down near the church a big way with a big stones. You know? That's the way that Jesus walked on.
So is this believed to be the place for Caiaphas the high priest?
Yes, we think that the palace of Caiaphas was in this part of the city. We didn't found this palace of Caiaphas. We have a good archaeologist from Spain. He excavated for 9 years. Every year he told me, I hope this time I will find the palace of Caiaphas. But for the moment he didn't find that. He think it was in this, not far from here. So that's also a good reason for us to have a place consecrated to the St. Peter, to the betrayal of St. Peter, and also to the prison of Jesus.
Now, beneath the church are some carved chambers. What would they have been used for?
Difficult to know. They can be also for to conserve, to have a water, big cisterns, maybe. But people think that they can be the prison of Jesus. It's difficult to be certain of that. But the pilgrims used to have a special memory of this place. So from a long time that they used to have two things. That's the place was the place of the prison of Jesus. Maybe not directly this place.
So this is possibly a site where Jesus was imprisoned. What's it like for you personally working on such a place where Jesus possibly was at?
Well, the prison, the place exactly, difficult to say. But I think for us, what is important, it's not the place, precise place, the context in this place. Near here, Jesus was arrested, and that's something important for us to understand, that Jesus was not a pure spirit. He was a man. He walked on this region, on the ground. He went in, and he was arrested here. That's a good sign of his humanity, a true humanity. He's not a spirit that came from the heaven like that. No, it's a man who very, very incarnated, and the incarnation is something very important.
Now, this is also believed to be the site where Peter denied Jesus.
Yes, that's more sure. It's in the souvenir of the past, the name of Galikanto was a name very, very old, and there was a name which has a link with this place. Galikanto means the song of the cock, because you remember in the gospel, Jesus said to Peter, I will give my life for you. And Jesus said, before the cock croak, yeah, you will betray me 3 times. And that's why the name of St. Peter is very important for us. It's the name of the biggest sin of a man against Jesus. He was a friend of Jesus. He spent 2 years with him. And at the moment when he have to be a witness of Jesus, he betrayed his master. And that's also a good sign for the church to remember all the time that his founder, Jesus, and the first to be who has the heritage of Jesus was a man who sinned against his master. The church is a church also of sinners.
What artifacts have you actually found on this site?
We found a lot of things, but you know that this place were devastated by the war, a lot of war, and a lot of things were stolen, and now we have not a lot of things, but in this place we found especially a good inscription which spoke about the Korban in Hebrew. Korban is a word which has linked with the sacrifice, and it's maybe an argument also to think that it was the place of the holy priest and the Caiaphas particularly.
Now you have very beautiful mosaics in the church today. What sort of pictures do they depict?
All the tree, the big mosaic are about the Peter. One is the place where Peter say, I don't know him. And the servant asked to Peter, you are also a disciple of Jesus? He said, no, I don't know him. That's the first. The second, when Peter is crying because he understands he did a very bad things against his mother, so he's crying. And the third, it's about the chapter 21 of the Gospel of John, when Jesus asked Peter, do you love me? Three times, same way as he betrayed three times, and St. Peter said, yes, I love you. You know that, Alfred. But so he told him, now be the pastor of my church.
So anybody who's a tourist coming to the church today, what would they see here?
But they will see, I think they will have, it depends on the people, because and there are a lot of people of, not all Catholic, they are Catholic, Protestant, also evangelical, but the place is important because for them it's the place where they can meet this souvenir of the passage of Jesus. Jesus came here. Jesus was sentenced here by Caiaphas to death. But Jesus was a man, God of man at the same time, but with the fidelity until the death. It's a place with a lot of moment very important for the people, and maybe the people from Asia, for example, so Korea, from China, from Japan, they like very much this place, maybe more than the people from Europe. I don't know why, but for them it's the discovery of the place is very nice, and that's also is important to make this visit a very good visit for them.
Now you have a statue outside. What's the statue of?
The statue of Peter, that Peter who is trying to betray the master, his mother, because he say, I don't know him, and he went to around the fire to try to find some company, because he think that to live in the fidelity with his master is very too hard, so he prefer to betray his master.
Now Peter changed after Jesus' death, and he became very, very powerful. What in history actually happened to Peter?
That's true. That we have a Peter. Some the father of the church said used to say it's very strange, because when Jesus was here, Peter was very weak and unable to follow his master until the end. But when the master left, when Jesus died and was risen, Jesus was no more physically with him. He was able to be in the fidelity until the death. That's very strange. That maybe that the strength of the faith also changed. He was weak when Jesus was with him, and very strong when Jesus left. That's the we can say the strength of the resurrection, the faith, new fidelity.
What happened to him in history?
Well, he died. You know, he was crucified in Rome with Paul, Peter and Paul, the two big apostles, and now we have near St. Peter in Rome, the place where the excavation found the place where he was murdered in more or less 62-63 after Christ.
Is it true he was crucified upside down because he didn't feel himself worthy to be crucified the same way as Jesus?
That's true, yes. Okay.
So what's your prayer for believers around the world at this time of the year?
Difficult to say. The prayer, first of all, we hope that the peace will come in this country. Jesus came here, Jesus was a man of peace, and Jesus remained for us a man who can give peace between the man, all the man in the world. So that's the first thing. Also for the pilgrims who will come this year, to hope that there will be for them a moment of conversion, also to meet the truth, Jesus as a man who can transform the life of people. That's for me important.